Hey everyone, thanks for stopping by my channel. Today I have 12, yes 12, stocking stuffers for you that I made using mostly Dollar Tree items, a couple of Dollar General and some other really inexpensive things, but I also used my Cricut for each one of these projects. I just wanted to show you guys how versatile it is to have a cutting machine, whether you have a Cricut, a Silhouette, a Brother Scan and Cut, whatever you have. These machines just make gift giving so easy. So I'm not gonna do tutorials, but I am just gonna show you ideas. If you have questions, drop them in the comments below. But let me go ahead and let me show you what I made for some stocking stuffers for my family. Now I got this brush from the Dollar Tree and I used some Lily Inspired 651 permanent vinyl. I'm gonna clean my surface with some alcohol and then just place the vinyl right on using some transfer tape. And that's it. This one is so easy, you guys, and it turned out so pretty. Now for the next one, I'm using this fleece baby blanket. I did get this from the Dollar Tree and I'm going to just use my Cricut Easy Press in the 12 by 12 size. I'm just gonna heat the area first, place my heat transfer vinyl on there. I am using parchment paper as a kind of in between there as I'm pressing. I did have my heat set on 250. I did this for 15 second intervals. I do think my heat was a little bit much for this fabric, so it is a little bit wrinkly, but once it kind of cooled off, it turned out perfectly fine. Now I'm gonna use a Dollar Tree mug, and I got this warm and cozy SVG off of Love SVG. You guys know I love them. And this one is super simple. I did it in two colors to make those hearts red. You could put hot chocolate, coffee, whatever you want, and this makes a great gift or stocking stuffer. Super easy to do. Now this one is a cosmetic bag or makeup bag I got from Dollar Tree, and I thought this was so pretty. And I had some metallic gold heat transfer vinyl, so that's what I'm using here. And this, most of these I'm just kind of putting a name on it or monogramming it for other people. I am using the heat on 250 for 15 second intervals, again with my Easy Press. I did use an old washcloth in between the bag there as I was pressing it. Now these night lights are really easy to do and a great way to kind of customize any room or area. So for this one, I did this for my son and just used black, and I got the image, the Batman image off of Google, and that's it. And they light up blue. These are so cute and make a nice little stocking stuffer or gift. And you could do so many different things with these night lights as well. Now this is actually a soap dish I got in Dollar Tree, and I'm going to be using it as a ring or jewelry dish for my niece. So I'm using this kind of metallic gold, and this is 651 permanent vinyl, and then I'm gonna put her name in purple, which is her favorite color, and that's it. Again, this one's really quick, just like the hairbrush. Now for my mom, I'm gonna use these cozy socks I got from Dollar Tree. And I have it where it says, if you can read this, bring me some wine. So you wanna flip your socks over to where, like if you were sitting on the couch and had your feet propped up, that you could read these. So I put my washcloth in between the socks there. And for this, I'm still on 250 and I'm doing 15 second intervals before peeling it off, and I'm still using my parchment paper in between. Again, just make sure when you're putting these on that you're doing it the right way, that your letters are gonna go the right way. So again, think of it as if you're sitting on the couch, propping your feet up, you want people to read it to where it says, if you can read this, bring me some wine. But these are everywhere this year. I've seen them in so many different sayings, and you can kind of customize that any way you'd like. Now for this one, I purchased this box template off of Design Space, the Cricut Design Space. Comes with a little snowflake. I did not cut the snowflake out, but I did cut the box out. I believe this only cost me 99 cents. If you have the subscription, it would be free for you. And I'm using this really pretty dark green textured paper to make this box. I just thought this green was so pretty for Christmas. And this is what it looks like. I do not have a scoring tool on my Cricut. So if you have a scoring board, you could always use that, something, but I'm just gonna use my ruler because I find that that's the easiest for me. Now I'm following the lines off of my computer, off of Design Space. I'm not just like making these lines up as I go along. So you'll kind of want to make sure you know where you're folding everything. And again, just using my ruler worked really, really well, and just kind of making sure your lines are nice and creased. And then I'm using my scrappy tape, just the half inch here, and I'm only using just a little bit on the tabs or the flaps that are gonna be folded in, just to make sure it stays adhered nice and well. I am going to be putting some bath bombs in here, and I actually thought I had some like shredded paper in red. I didn't. So what I would recommend is maybe putting something in here to cushion that bath bomb, so it's not just like rolling around in the box, because the box is slightly bigger than the actual bath bomb. It doesn't need to be this big. So again, just put you some filler in there. And I had these stickers from the Dollar Tree, so I thought I would go all the way around and put different ones on each side. You could add ribbon, you could cut something else out with your Cricut, like that snowflake or whatever design you like. Now these coloring cards are super easy to do and kids love them. I already have this set up as a design in Design Space. I've used it before. I believe you can purchase it for like 99¢ or something from Design Space as well. But I added the image of the tree and I wrote Merry Christmas. Prints out on cardstock out of your regular printer, and then you run it through your machine and the machine cuts it. So it's called a print and cut feature. And this is what it looks like once it's done. And I just got that tree image off of Google. I just Googled it and uploaded it into Design Space. And then here I'm just going to add two crayons, and they just slide right in those little holes there, so it cuts it perfect. And kids love these, and you can customize these any way you'd like. These are just such a great little gift. Now for these gloves, my Dollar Tree did not have gloves, or they don't have them yet, maybe at this time. I know other Dollar Trees do, but I got these at Dollar General. They were a 2-pack for $3, so these were $1.50. I'm just going to put my son's monogram on here, and this is just the way I like to do a boy's monogram. So these turned out really cute, and I think he'll really like those. Now for this phone charger, I actually got this at Five Below for $5. My husband and I are always fighting over whose charger and where's the charger, and this one's mine and this one's yours and whatever. So I decided to go ahead and put my monogram on mine so he can't say that it's his anymore. So I just like these colors, and this was, again, really, really easy to do and a great way to customize some things, especially if you have a lot of people in the household or multiple children. So just another great easy project. Now this one, these are chapstick holders. They're like neoprene fabric, and they're keychain holders as well. I got this off of 651 vinyl. They're like 250, I believe. I'll leave everything in the description box below for you so you guys can go purchase this stuff. But this is just another really inexpensive. It's not Dollar Tree, but I know some Dollar Generals, I've seen these before, but I haven't this year. But I decided to use this camo vinyl and just put my nephew's name on there, and the lip balm just fits right in. And again, it's a keychain as well. And you can see this one that I made for myself out of that Lily inspired fabric. And these are just another really cute and inexpensive way to give a gift and make it customized. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. There was a lot of information in here. I'm going to leave links below in my description box. So please make sure you check out the description box, because if you have a Cricut, you will be able to click on some of my links. They are shareable, so you can go in and create some of these designs right from what I already have made. And if you're new here, thanks for stopping by. Please make sure you subscribe before you leave. And if you want to see more videos, hit that little bell and you'll be notified every time I upload a video. Thank you so much for watching. As always, you guys have a great day.